Hi and welcome. Today at PowerJackRepair.net we got a Samsung RC512, also known as NP-RC512. The problem with the laptop is when you plug in the cord, it's extremely loose right here. Let me show you on the different angle. Basically, I can pull it out like that. Put it in like that and it's pretty loose, so it doesn't make a good contact inside. The plug tests out to be fine. It just really, I mean, it shouldn't be that loose coming in and out like that, right? You always have to use the two fingers to plug in, plug out, but this is extremely loose. So let's take it apart. Let me show you different angles so that you could see that nothing is hidden. And what we do is we replace the jacks for $100 total, or $60 if you send us just the motherboard. And the reason we make the videos is so that if you want, you could send us just the motherboard. First, we pry out those two rubber pieces right here because they got hidden screws under them. And then let's switch the camera views. This is this one, no, that one. Like that. All right. Well, let's begin taking it apart. So, if you can see something, if I'm covering something with the left hand, you can see it on the front camera. Or better yet, hold on. Let me do this like that. All right. All right, let's begin. You know what, somebody already taken most of the screws out. Alright, so we got three screws here. And we got there. What I'm gonna do is I wanna pry out this piece right here. I got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 right there. By the way, don't forget to leave us a like, because nobody else is gonna have so many different ways of showing you how the repair is done. Now what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to carefully remove the cable for the hard drive. Don't pull on the cable itself, just set it aside. And I think we are done here on the bottom. Let's see if you get any screws on the top. Nothing on the top. So let's try and pry it out a little bit. What I'm trying, we'll try to do first, I'm trying to put the small plastic piece like that. Now none of the cameras show anything here, like that. that doesn't want to go in. So next what we're gonna do is this. Try not to jam anything too far in, because there are going to be motherboard there as well as coolant water pad. So you don't want to scratch anything farther in. So the button cover is almost, well, it moves, so that's a good sign. Okay. Alrighty. There we go. Alright then, here is the jack, and what's broken inside is the spring that's supposed to grab onto this pin on the side. So when you push it in, there's a spring right here that springs in and out. I will show you a little bit later. So right now let's do like that. And like that. Alrighty, so here we got the black hinge that we're supposed to slowly move to the left and remove the cable like that. Then we got another hinge right here, move the cable outwards. Another cable right here. Like that. Try not to break anything, so like that. Like that. And here we got, let's mark which one goes where. Remove this cable like that, and disconnect it. Now we're moving towards this end like that. Okay, like that. And here we got the fan. And the most important cable is right here, which you don't want to damage for sure. Alright, here's what I'm gonna here is slightly different. I'll try and push it out through the inside. Feels like somebody glued it in, but it's mostly a cheap plastic, cheap Chinese plastic that you wanna break inside, outside, anywhere. I'm not pulling on the cable, I'm just seeing if this insulation is maybe holding it down a little bit on the bottom. There is nothing holding it on the top. Okay, like that. Alright. Alrighty. So now that everything is unscrewed, you want to remove the heatsink. Alright, so heatsink removed. We can also clean the thermal paste right now, so it wouldn't be all over the soldering place here. Like that. Okay, now back to here. Right, so here we got three components on the bottom side. Here, let me show you. Those three components right here. Sure, it's 2534 UX. So says something like Asus UX 2534 or something like that, not like UX afterwards. Usually it says, usually the model goes as Asus, UX, and then the numbers. In the model you provided, it's UX at the end for some reason. So, I know that 2534 is the processor you got on the laptop. That's fine, we can fix it, no worry about it. Sir, how much you paid for the car? Well, sir, I can't really do any discount on the screws. But I could give you 10 bucks off, it's not a big deal. Sir, all the parts are the same. I mean, it's not like somebody is knocking the parts off. Everybody has exactly the same parts. So. If we're gonna use our part of the one you're gonna be shipping it with, it's the same part. It's all, there's no difference in that. No.
Alright.
Well, it's usually 100 bucks if you ship the whole laptop, or it's 60 bucks if you assemble just the motherboard. Yeah, you can take everything off. I wouldn't touch the processor because I think in your case the processor is part of the motherboard. Could be part of the motherboard. So. Sure. But I mean, whatever you want to take off, take off. We don't need most of it. Sir, I can just text you the website address and you could just copy all the information from there. It's up to you. I mean, you could pay online or you could send a check in a box or you could send cash in a box, whatever works for you. So it doesn't matter for us. Sir, I can text it to you, all right? All right, okay, thanks. Sir, you're breaking up. Sir, you're breaking up. Sir? Yeah. Sure. Once we receive it, we ship it the next day. So don't worry about it. I will just text the address and send the thing whenever you have time. All right. Thank you so much. All right, sorry about that, guys. The best way to contact us is just text us or email us, or better not call us or email us. It just takes time out of my day, out of your day, and everything is on the website, everything is on the videos. I'm not sure what kind of questions can one ask. Everything is written. I mean, we've been in business 18 years, so every single question that you might have, it's all on the website. But people like to call because of the unlimited phone usage nowadays. Here, like that. So let's put this like that. Because it has too many components on the this side, so we don't want to heat up the area where it's not supposed to be heated. So let's find another jack like that. It's a 3-leg straight. Same jack. Wonderful. Let's desolder it. So
All right. So now we're putting the new connector in. Не, самому надо развеяться, сколько он будет сидеть сама.
Alrighty, so the reason I had to add solder to those two components right here at the bottom is to those two surface mounted components so that they conduct the positive end of the current, and sometimes because they're surface mounted, because of too much wiggling, the component might be slightly off the motherboard. So that's the reason we add a little bit of solder to the two components right here. All right, so clean it a little bit. Clean it. Here. All right, and now you can see it, it's like brand new. You see? All right, let's measure the current to make sure the negative is conducting, positive has some resistance. On this one it's really low resistance, so yep, good. Let's assemble it all back together. Okay, so the trick is, it's really hard to pull, to put this cable into the motherboard when the motherboard is in place. So what we want to do is, alright, so what we want to do is, we want to guide the connector in place, and then we want to, there is a little knob right here, like that. Like that. Okay, so now we connect this cable. Make sure it's all the way in. Let's see, I don't want to push it in too hard. I want to make sure that all of the pins are straight. And if you're sure that all of the pins are straight, you want to... Everything's straight, so I'm not sure why it's not wanna go easily in. This is there is no cable in there for that. Okay, so here, 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 right here. Now let's put the... Let's wipe out the extra... Okay. Let's put it here. So we put some Arctic silver. Like that. clean, right? And now we wanna put in the put the wireless card in, screw it in. Okay, wonderful. Looks good, everything looks good. One thing I wanna do is I wanna put some protection from the heat, from the heatsink, because the heat gonna accumulate and mess up the, right here. Like that. Okay, good job. Like that, and like that. Alrighty, guys. Leave a like because that's the least you can do. Let's put in the CD-ROM. Let's plug in the okay, like that. And we got two thick screws that go right here. I think they're all the same, by the way. They just seem thick because compared to usual, a lot of the kind of thick. So this is goes here, and one goes right here. Okay, so this time we put them like that, like that. Let's put one tab right there. Here we also see that one of the memory chips isn't sitting properly. So my guess, you see how the bracket right there is kind of to the side. So something isn't right with that chip, or it's something isn't right with this cooling mechanism. So let's redo the... Okay, see how it went in properly? And now what you want to do is you want to make sure this is all nice and straight and like that. So now that this one is holding, all four are holding, what I want to do is I want to put some tape right there so that the springing mechanism would not spring out and it would be always in the proper place. And the chips are not gonna move while I'm shipping. So here we close it like that. And then we like that. Like that, like that. Okay. And server, that. Like that. Like that. And like that. Good job. We need one more right there, which we don't have, but I'm sure the client has it. So let's flip it over, open this thing up, and let's connect the jack right there. And if you try to connect it just by the cable, you see it's not gonna go in. So you have to push it in, unplug it, push it in, okay? And let's hope it's gonna work. Yep, something's supposed to come up right now, right there. There is no battery inside, so everything is connected to the cord. I wiggle it around, make sure that the cord is fine. I wiggle around the cord right here as well, make sure it's not gonna fall down. I wiggle around the C cable. It says that there is no bootable device. And again, let me show you that it should be working fine. See, there is light. And yeah, Samsung right there. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Leave a like, and if you want us to fix it, again, powerjackrepair.net, $100. We're gonna take care of it. Alright, thanks so much. Have a good day. Bye.